This innovative wind turbine, namely the cross-axis wind turbine, is a breakthrough design that could displace the current wind turbine technology. It complements the vertical axis wind turbine and horizontal axis wind turbine. There are two types of wind turbines, and both of them have their advantages and disadvantages. The horizontal axis wind turbine is effective in generating electricity and it is easy to self-start, but it can only accept the wind from one direction, which is not suitable for the urban areas. It needs yaw mechanism to direct the wind turbine rotor into the wind direction. Moreover, the heavy and critical components are mounted on top of a tower and it causes a high center of gravity issue. One of the advantages of the vertical axis wind turbine is it can accept the wind from all direction and also generate power at lower wind speeds for drag type turbine. However, the disadvantages of vertical axis wind turbine is it has relatively low inefficiency and poor in starting behavior. The major problem of the wind turbine is the reliability of mechanical parts, especially the bearing gearbox and yaw mechanism. All these critical components are heavy and mounted on top of the tower. These cause the high costs and worker safety issue during installation and maintenance. The Global Wind Report shows that the wind turbine market is huge and is growing fast. The energy generated by the wind is equivalent to 1.2 trillion ton of coal per year. In order to overcome the disadvantages of existing wind turbine design, cross-axis wind turbine is introduced. It is a new type of wind turbine and can be the third turbine category of wind turbine in the future. It can capture wind energy from both the horizontal and vertical directions. The major difference is the horizontal arms or the supporting arms of the vertical axis wind turbine were replaced as aerofoil-shaped arms. This design will generate about 1.6 times power with the same space or volume compared to vertical axis wind turbines, since the force generation surface is doubled. The two-layer horizontal arms or blades will create the aero levitation forces that lifts up the whole rotor, or it give the force that counter the weight of the rotating rotor. By having this effect, it means the force that acts on a bearing is reduced. Hence, the life of bearing will be extended. And, both the layer upper lower horizontal arms are offset by 60 degrees, and this produces better force distribution in rotation cycle. Lab testing was conducted to compare the performance of the new cross-axis wind turbine design with the existing vertical axis wind turbine. It is obvious that the cross-axis wind turbine has a better starting behavior, and it achieved higher RPM, which is about 1.6 times higher than the vertical axis wind turbine. So, from the performance comparison, it can be concluded that we can double the energy output with the new wind turbine design with just 15% increase in cost, as shown in the graph. With these advantages, this revolutionary design of the cross-axis wind turbine can potentially displace the existing wind turbine rotor technology. This design will improve wind energy output by maximizing the wind energy power generation with both the vertical and horizontal blades. It also possesses good self-starting capability, which does not require external assistance in order to start up. The heavy components can be placed at the lower level and make the whole system has a lower center of gravity. Maintenance and operation cost is reduced due to aero levitation forces generated by the cross-axis wind turbine, which lowers the friction in the bearing and generator. This new design can be used as the standalone wind turbine, or it can be integrated with the buildings for urban applications. When the cross-axis wind turbine is mounted on the top of high-rise building, it not only generates energy from the high-altitude wind but also can capture the upward draft from the wind deflected by the building facade. The global small wind power market is expected to reach US$2 billion in 2019 with a CAGR rate of about 20%. The offshore wind turbine market is expanding due to fewer obstructions and higher wind speed. The bigger potential can be the offshore application, where the annual market is reaching 130 million by 2020. This invention or innovative design had gained various recognitions in countries like Malaysia, Singapore, Indonesia, and China. Thank you. Move the wind turbine technology further,